So don't say anything. Don't even make a sound. Cause at this point, I just want to know that you're around. Don't question.
Hi there. Welcome back to Dear Sybersue Advice Talk Show. Today's topic is be aware of what they don't say on a date. So this is for both men and women. When we're on a date, we're told to watch out for red flags. Listen to what they say. If they say things that are, you know, all about them, they're not asking questions about you, or they're talking about their ex, or all these things. Those are things they're saying that are pretty obvious that you kind of have to look out for, right? But what about what they don't say? So say you ask them a question about something, about what's going on in their life. When was the last time they dated somebody? And they're being really evasive with a lot of their answers. What they're not saying there is actually saying a lot, because they don't want to deal with it. They don't want to be giving you too much information about what's going on. Now, this could be just a protection thing because they don't know you, so why are you asking all these questions? They don't want to give out too much information. But there's also time to ask questions that you really do need to know the answers to, because if you're going to sit there and give them another date down the road, you want a few things kind of out of the way. You want to have some safety questions as well that you want to ask. And anytime they're being evasive or they're changing the subject, or all of a sudden they turn it around and turn the question on you, they're avoiding something. So when somebody's in avoidance of certain questions that are just basic everyday questions, really listen to your spidey senses. Your gut is going to tell you something loud and clear. Don't ignore it. Ask the question again. If they are repetitively ignoring answering your questions, you've got your answer that there's something they're hiding. Watch their body language. How are they dealing with things? If they turn away from you when you ask a question, do they look at you when they answer you? Or are they sort of answering you and then changing the subject right away? So I'm not telling you to get a checklist out, because that I'm totally against. You want to ask a few really good questions when you're on those first few dates and just let the conversation flow. But if you notice that it's kind of stopping and starting all the time, there isn't a nice sort of even-keeled connection happening here. There's something they don't want to talk about, or there's something maybe that they're holding in within themselves they don't want to share. Whatever it is, it's going to put a blip into you and this person moving on to maybe a second date. Because you're going to start thinking that, well, what's up with that? Why can't they just answer a simple question? Or why are they avoiding answering something that's really, I don't know, pretty basic that I would want to be asked myself? These are things that are why we date. And so when people get frustrated with dating and say, oh my God, you know, it wasn't a good date, or well, I saw them two times and I never really got to know them because they didn't give me any part of who they are. Well, it's because they're being reserved, removed, and they're not maybe ready to date, or maybe you're just not a really good combination together. So in the first couple of days, it should be pretty smooth. If there's that many questions and that many things that aren't being answered, or you feel that they're being secretive about stuff, you might want to just move on to the next person, because you shouldn't have to put that much energy into the first couple of dates with somebody. So that's a really good rule of thumb to follow. If there's questions that you want to know that are very, very simple and easygoing, and they're being like, whoa, guarded about everything, that's a lot of work for you to go in and put that time into somebody who doesn't really want to give you that. So I don't know. Personally, I would say if you're getting a lot of that on dates, either change up your question line. Maybe you're asking too many questions. Simplify them. And if you're finding that you're just getting a lot of people who are secretive, they're not ready to date, maybe move on and start changing up who you are going on a date with, because there could be a bit of a pattern here. Maybe you're attracting people who are unobtainable, or just who are not into a commitment sort of situation. So make sure you know when you go on a date what you want on that date, okay? So that's my conversation for today. Thanks so much for tuning in to Dear Sybersue. Please like the video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks, everyone. Bye-bye.